Dante Gabriel Rossetti, painter and poet, was born on the 12th of May 1828 in London and attended King's College School between 1837 and 1841, showing no particular aptitude for either literature or painting. He joined Henry Sass's Drawing Academy at Bloomsbury Street in 1841 and attended irregularly until 1845, whilst adopting a bohemian lifestyle. He read widely, including the works of Shelley and Coleridge, French fiction, Gothic novels, and early Italian poetry. After several failed applications, Rossetti entered the Antique Academy of the Royal Academy in December 1845, but could not adopt its conservative regime. In 1847, he applied to Ford Madox Brown, whom he saw as a more sympathetic spirit, for private tuition in painting and drawing. At this time, 1847, he was steadily writing poetry, including early versions of The Blessed Damozel. He also experimented with what was then little known early Italian poets. His early literary heroes were Poe, Browning, and Blake. In 1848, Rossetti met William Holman Hunt and John Everett Millais, and they formed a sketching club for which Rossetti's first contribution was La Belle Dame sans Merci. In around 1849, the group, with some others, formed the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood, and in the same year, Rossetti sold The Girlhood of Mary Virgin for £80, which is equivalent to £8,000 in today's money. An illustration to Robert Browning's poem, The Laboratory, set in the 18th century, is Rossetti's first work in watercolour. An alchemist seated in his laboratory accepts jewellery from a woman in payment for poison to destroy her rival. The painting illustrates the lines, "In this devil's smithy, where is the poison to poison her prithee?" Later that year, Rossetti and Holman Hunt went to Paris to visit and admire many of the artistic treasures there, and on returning to England, Rossetti painted Ecce Ancilla Domine, or The Annunciation. This painting was widely criticized in the press and remained unsold. In future, Rossetti, unlike Holman Hunt and John Millais, refused to publicly show his work, but worked almost entirely through private communication. In 1850, Rossetti translated Dante's Vita Nuova, which he eventually published in 1861. At this time, he produced some fine watercolors and drawings, which he kept or sold to friends. Elizabeth Siddal, whom he met in 1850 while she was sitting for one of his friends, Walter Deverell. Rossetti subsequently became involved with Elizabeth, drawing and painting her frequently. Thank you. The purchase of Rossetti's Annunciation for £50, equivalent to £6,000 in today's money, in 1853, together with his positive meeting with the famous art critic John Ruskin, marked a change in his fortunes. When, in 1853, Rossetti painted Dante drawing an angel, Ruskin so admired the painting, he visited Rossetti in his studio and they became good friends. At that time, the artist Barbara Lee Smith described Rossetti as a slim Italian, English-born and bred, but a son of Italy. Short, dark hair, lighter eyes, a little moustache and a beard. Very gentlemanly, even tender in nature, with a sweet, mellow voice. Found, 1854, was posed by Fanny Cornforth, with whom Rossetti had one of his longest standing relationships and with whom he was involved over many years. Fanny Cornforth's tenderness for Rossetti lasted until his death in 1882. In 1855, Robert and Elizabeth Browning invite Rossetti and his brother William to dine. On a second occasion, Tennyson was also present, and Rossetti drew him whilst he was reading his poem, Maud. In 1855, Rossetti sold his Paolo and Francesco da Rimini from Dante's Hell. A sustained friendship between Rossetti and Edward Burne-Jones began in 1856, when they met after Burne-Jones had written a most complimentary tribute to Rossetti's illustration of William Allingham's Maids of Elfin Moor. Rossetti also made illustrations for the 1857 Moxham printing to Tennyson's poems. In 1858, J. Seddon, friend and architect, who had been involved in refurbishing Landraff Cathedral, suggested Rossetti should be chosen to design a new altarpiece, a triptych, The Seed of David. Burne Jones introduced Rossetti to William Morris, who bought some drawings, and John Ruskin introduced him to the Bostonian Charles Eliot Norton, who commissioned a portrait of the critic. Medieval legend subjects dominated Rossetti's works in the 1850s. In 1857, Rossetti, who always had an eye for what he termed stunners, noticed Jane Burden at an Oxford theatre. He asked her to sit for him. Later, Jane became Mrs. William Morris and also Rossetti's lover. The actress Ruth Herbert appeared in Rossetti's following paintings. At this time, Rossetti wrote a poem on the subject of sexual arousal, The Song of the Bower. One manuscript version was given a subtitle, which it shares with one of Rossetti's most important painted works, Bocca Bacchiata, Kiss Mouth, 1859, where he painted Fanny Cornforth as a robust Renaissance courtesan. The work was a stunner in the opinion of Algernon Swinburne, but artist William Holman Hunt and others saw it as indecent. Annie Miller was a model who posed for William Holman Hunt and Dante Rossetti. Thank you. In the following year, 1860, Rossetti made it known that he would be marrying the ailing Elizabeth Siddle. Following the honeymoon in Paris, he painted How They Met Themselves, 1860. Fanny Cornforth was dismissed. In 1861, Elizabeth gave birth to a stillborn child, and evidence suggests that she suffered from postnatal depression. In 1861, Rossetti drew illustrations for his sister Christina's collection of poems, Goblin Market. He also became very involved in William Morris's Arts and Crafts firm. In December 1861, Rossetti's translation and publication of early Italian poems was well received. But this good news was overshadowed by the death of his wife Elizabeth, due to an overdose of laudanum. The facts point to suicide. At her burial, Rossetti placed a calf-bound manuscript copy of his poems in the coffin beside Elizabeth's body. In 1862, Rossetti's youthful interest in William Blake was rekindled, and he offered to help edit selections of Blake's work for the unfinished biography, which appeared in 1863. The publication drew attention to a very largely neglected body of work. In 1863, Fanny Cornforth moved into Rossetti's highly unconventional household at Tudor House, Cheyne Walk, Chelsea, and Rossetti's renewed intimacy with her is recorded in his painting Fazio's Mistress, 1863. From 1862 to 64, Rossetti produced and sold 40 small and medium-sized paintings, including 11 oils. He had a circle of good-looking female models. Began to appear prominently in Rossetti's works during the mid-1860s. At this time, Rossetti was helping his sister Christina revise her poems for the Prince's Progress. After Elizabeth's death in 1862, her memory began to haunt Rossetti, and he began his most famous image of her, Beata Beatrix, 1864-70. Let him kiss me with kisses of the mouth, for thy love is better than wine. ¶¶ In 1865, relations deteriorated between John Ruskin and Rossetti, partly due to Ruskin's dislike of Rossetti's Venus Verticordia. In April 1866, Rossetti began a commissioned work, Lady Lilith, 1868, with Fanny Cornforth. This picture was altered in future years by substituting the head of Alexa Wilding for the original Fanny Cornforth. Until 1866, Rossetti had not drunk alcohol to excess. Now he joined in the heavy drinking sessions in Cheyne Walk. Life in Tudor House was slovenly and sometimes dissipating, and Rossetti descended into a state of neglect. In 1863, he had caught mumps that may have left him with excess fluid in the scrotum, which gave him continuous trouble, which was later compounded by a serious eye problem. Rossetti found his eyes sensitive to sunshine and he suffered from insomnia. An important oculist named Bader told him that his problem was psychological rather than physiological. This time, Rossetti became seriously infatuated with Jane Morris, whom he had always admired and who had in return enjoyed his company. Although the affair at this stage may have been purely platonic, two of Rossetti's poems from this period, The Orchard Pit and Doom of the Sirens, are both nervously concerned with the consequences of illicit desire. Rossetti started composing poetry to celebrate the joy of newly awakened love, inspired by Jane Morris, and he continued to draw her obsessively. Thank you. The publication of Rossetti's poem in the Fortnightly Review reawakened his desire for success in this field. In 1869, he had 50 sonnets printed in proof, which he sent to his brother William with a view to publication. And importantly, he had his valuable collection of early poems removed from his late wife Elizabeth's coffin. Rossetti now meticulously and painstakingly revised his poetic works, helped by his brother William, and later by his friend Algernon Swinburne. Rossetti's health was deteriorating. Eye pain and tremors in his hands sent him to Sir William Jenner, who registered he stopped work for a while. Rossetti's insomnia improved in response to doses of chloral hydrate. On the 25th of April, 1870, Rossetti's poems were published. Given the explicitly sexual nature of many of the sonnets, Rossetti was anxious about reviews. However, the reviews were mainly favourable and gave him the confidence to reissue his early Italian poets. In June 1872, Rossetti suffered a breakdown, the symptoms being a persecution mania, and at a suicide attempt, he drank a complete phial of laudanum and remained comatose for 36 hours. At Cheyne Walk, he was looked after by Ford Madox Brown and others, and he was visited occasionally by Jane Morris. William Graham offered a convalescent retreat in Perthshire, and Dr. Thomas Hake accepted on his behalf. Rossetti was now taking whiskey and chloral hydrate, with his carers trying to regulate the dose. In July, Rossetti moved with Dr. Thomas Hake to a farmhouse in Trowan, where he rapidly improved. On September the 24th, he travelled back to England, where he was reunited with Jane. Rossetti kept up his connection with Fanny Cornforth, although he would not let her visit him. Back in 1864, Walter Dunlop had commissioned for 2,000 guineas, that's approximately £242,000 in today's money, The Boat of Love. In mid-October 1875, Rossetti rented a house in Bognor Regis, and Alexa Wilding came to sit for Blessed Damozel. The Blessed Damozel is Rossetti's best-known poem, first published in 1850 and later revised and republished in 1856, 1870 and 1873. He also used the same title for one of his best-known paintings. The poem describes the damozel looking down on her lover from heaven and her unrequited yearning for their union in heaven. The first four stanzas are inscribed on the painting's frame. The first stanza goes as follows. The blessed damozel leaned out from the gold bar of heaven. Her eyes were deeper than the depth of waters stilled at even. She had three lilies in her hand, and the stars in her hair were seven. Rossetti now sank in spirits, and his consumption of chloral hydrate remained high. Jane Morris said that his addiction would make future visits difficult. Dr. Jenner had prescribed 20 grains a day, but in 1877 he was taking 180 a day. In 1880, Rossetti completed one of his last finished works, Joan of Arc. During summer 1881, Rossetti went to Cumberland with Fanny Cornforth and had a thoroughly jolly time, but on returning to London, Rossetti seemed to his brother William to be very ill. On the 11th of December, Rossetti suffered a mild stroke, and in February 1882, his old friend Seddon invited him to Kent. where he was visited by friends. On Sunday, the 9th of April, Easter Day, Rossetti died. Rossetti's artwork features predominantly in many public collections in Britain: Birmingham Museum and Art Gallery, Tate London, British Museum, Manchester City Art Galleries, Fitzwilliam Museum, Cambridge, Ashmolean Museum, Oxford. Abroad, Fogg Art Museum, Harvard University, has a distinguished collection, as has the Samuel and Mary Bancroft Collection at Wilmington, Delaware. His works fetch astronomical prices when available at public auction.